مرشد بلا وردي. الله الله بالمهيمن لا بري مولاي ضد دائما أبدي.
صدق الله العلي العظيم. In the name of Allah, most gracious, most merciful, all praise is due to our Creator, our Cherisher, our Nourisher, and our Sustainer. We bear witness there's none worthy of worship but Allah. And we bear witness that we believe in all the prophets who came in the great line of divine. And we bear witness that Prophet Muhammad ibn Abdullah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa ashabihi wa sallam, is the final of all the emissaries of Allah. Respected ulama, respected elders, sisters and brothers, respected youth, I greet you with the Islamic universal greeting of peace. May the peace, the mercy and the blessings of Allah be upon each and everyone present here this evening. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. On behalf of the Islamia College Board of Trust, on behalf of the Islamia family, I wish to extend a welcome to each and every one of you to this very special program, a program done in collaboration with Islamia College and the Muslim Judicial Council, as well as Medina Institute. And it's a privilege for me to be asked to extend that welcome to you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our efforts. Somehow Allah has a way of bringing people together. And I think we should value these opportunities and these moments. Life has become very fragile, increasingly so. An increasingly non-caring world, where we are almost forced to be preoccupied with ourselves and less occupied even with the spiritual dimensions of ourselves, and even further less occupied with the well-being of others. I see on stage here my friend from childhood, slightly ahead of me, I used to try to emulate him initially, Sheikh Muhammad Murat, who was at that time studying by Sheikh Saleh Abadi. He finished and I started, by the way. So childhood friends in a way, and then Sheikh Mukhtar Ahmad, we were at Qari Nurbai together. And who would think someone from Freiburg and somebody was from Paul and somebody from Johannesburg, you know, we would go our own ways, and after so many years, I won't say how many years, but some, we come together and we are able to share a platform, and Allah brings hearts together. Let's appreciate that, inshallah. We are here to commemorate the lives of great people, people who are exemplary, people who serve as models of excellence, who are in the shadows of the prophets. But what are the characteristics, are the foundations of what make people great? When we say people are great people, what are great people? Mature in experience, unquestioned loyalty to truth and justice, selfless devotion, adherence to inspired principles that if enacted will benefit humanity, continual effort to increase understanding of those principles and the manifesting of it, acting upon those principles consistently throughout one's life. Today in particular, our focus is on someone, Abdullah bin Abi Quhafa, or as he's popularly known as Abu Bakr or Abu Bakr. More popular, I think, Abu Bakr rather. Radiallahu anhu. A person of unique distinction in that he's referred to in the Holy Quran on more than one occasion. A person who outside the family of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was the first senior male to accept Islam. And he did so without reluctance, without any hesitation, without any argumentation. First person outside the family of the Prophet. First senior male to embrace Islam. And a man who did that without hesitation, without reluctance, without argumentation. He was the first person to liberate slaves in the name of Allah in a society steeped in slavery. And we have a different form of slavery, mental enslavement and social enslavement and economic enslavement today. He had the unique distinction of being the companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Mount Thur, to be the second one. ثاني اثنين إذ هما في الغار إذ يقول لصاحبه لا تحزن إن الله معنا. The companion referred to there, the sahib referred to there, is Abu Bakr and no one other than that. And scholars are unanimous about that. Distinction of being the first khalif in the history of Islam, first person to gather the Quran, not in a book form, but gather the Quran, what they call a mushaf in some form, not necessarily in a book form necessarily. Had the unique distinction of being given the honorific title by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as-Siddiq, والذي جاء بصدق وصدق به. The Prophet is the one who brought the truth in. He was the one who testified to the truth. And you know the greatness of people when you know what other great people say about them. Sayyidina Ali karramallahu wajha, later to be the fourth Khalif of Islam, son-in-law of the Prophet, and together with Sayyidina Abu Bakr, the first two males to embrace Islam. At the funeral of Sayyidina Abu Bakr, you know, you live your life, he gave an oration. And part of the oration of Sayyidina Ali karramallahu wajha, the fourth Khalif, the one who was Sayyidina Abu Bakr, the first of the three Muslims, Khadija, Abu Bakr, and Ali radiallahu anhu. He said, وَكُنْتَ أَصْوَبُهُمْ مَنْطِقًا وَأَطْوَلُهُمْ سَمْتًا وَأَبْلَغُهُمْ قَوْلًا وَأَكْثَرُهُمْ رَأْيًا وَأَزْجَعَهُمْ نَفْسًا وَأَشْرَفَهُمْ عَمْلًا. He said, paying tribute to the man who's passed away, he said, you had the lowest voice, but the highest distinction. Your conversation was most exemplary, and your reasoning was most just. Your silence was prolonged, and your speech was eloquent. Bravest amongst men, most informed about matters, most dignified in action. Today, we have numerous scholars who are going to speak about this person who lived by the side of the Prophet, attested to the truth of the Prophet, never doubted or wavered, and not only that, even in death, he lies buried next to the Prophet. So no one can go and visit the Prophet without having to visit Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. The distinction of being by the side of the Prophet, even in death. And so too, perhaps, more in the hereafter, inshallah. So it's about the life and the legacy of this companion of the Prophet. There are esteemed scholars, Sheikh Muhammad Murad, Sheikh Ihsan Nadwi, Sheikh Riyad Walls, and a bit later on, Sheikh Muhammad bin Yahya al-Nanawi will further enlighten us here this evening. But let me conclude as I began by welcoming you once again on behalf of the Islamic College and all its components. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless this gathering with barakah, with meaning, with understanding. And the love we have come with, may we go back with much more, a stronger bond of love and affection and respect for each other. And better informed. Shukran. I now call upon Qari Abdul Rashid Brown, who will read a short recitation of the Holy Quran, and it will be followed by some short qasida by Sheikh Abdul Rashid and joined by Qari Yusuf Khan, inshallah. Shukran. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألم نشرح لك صدرك ووضعنا عنك وزرك الذي أنقض ظهرك ورفعنا لك ذكرك فإن مع العسر يسرا إن مع العسر يسرا فَإِذَا فَرَغْتَ فَانْصَبْ وَإِلَى رَبِّكَ فَارْغَبْ. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والتين والزيتون وطور سينين وهذا البلد الأمين لقد خلقنا الإنسان في أحسن تقويم. ثم رددناه أسفل سافلين. فما يكذبك بعد بالدين؟ أليس الله بأحكم الحاكمين؟ بسم الله خلق الإنسان من علق. اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم. الذي علم بالقلم علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم. كلا إن الإنسان ليطغى أن رآه استغنى. إن إلى ربك الرجعى. أرأيت الذي ينهى عبدا إذا صلى؟ أرأيت إن كان على الهدى أو أمر بالتقوى؟ أرأيت إن كذب وتولى؟ ألم يعلم بأن الله يرى؟ صدق الله العظيم. عظيم.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، محمد رسول الله، عليه وآله صلى الله. يحصل الأمان. كرر أيها الإنسان، لا إله إلا الله، الله لا إله إلا الله،
لا إله إلا الله، محمد رسول الله، عليه وآله صلى الله.
لقد آتانا في الأخبار عن المصطفى المختار أن أفضل الأذكار لا إله إلا الله، الله لا
إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله،
محمد رسول الله، عليه وآله صلى الله. قد آتانا في الأصول عن الحبيب الرسول أن خير ما نقول لا إله إلا الله، الله لا إله إلا الله، لا هي شفاء الصدور، هي نور على نور، ذكر ربك الغفور، لا إله إلا الله، الله
لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، محمد رسول الله، عليه وآله صلى الله. الله خير خلقي عند الله، صاحب العز والجاه، خاتم رسل الإله، محمد رسول الله،
الله لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا محمد رسول الله، عليه وآله صلى الله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله.
جزاكم الله خير to all the presenters for their beautiful presentations, to Sheikh Saadullah Khan for that beautiful and very explanatory and informative introduction to our program, inshallah. Respected brothers and sisters, let us get underway with our program. Inshallah, we have arranged with
with the masjid that will delay Isha for just a bit, inshallah. But without further ado, I want to introduce to you a very good friend of ours, an individual who we all know, and he needs no introduction. But just to complete the protocol of this evening, we wish to introduce Sheikh Riyad Walls, who heads the Al-Imam As-Suyuti Institute, who is prolific in his presentation of knowledge in this community. I often find that my inbox is populated with courses and programs that, mashallah, Sheikh offers on a weekly and a monthly basis. I think one of his new courses, he hasn't asked me to advertise this, is something to do with the raising or the upbringing of children, mashallah. So without further ado, our friend and colleague, and Allah has blessed us in the community with a wonderful individual, Sheikh Riyad Walls. He will deal with some aspects of the superiority of Sayyiduna Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. Falyatafadhal mashkura.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وأصلي وأسلم صلاة وتسليما يلقان بمقام أمير الأنبياء وإمام المرسلين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وعظيمنا وحبيبنا محمدا رسول الله خاتم الأنبياء والمرسلين صل اللهم وسلم وبارك على هذا النبي الأمين وعلى آله وصحابته الغر الميمين أما بعد respected ulama, elders, mothers and fathers, brothers and sisters in Islam, I greet you all with universal greetings of love, mercy and peace. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Before I entered this auditorium this evening, I was just going through some of my notes. And so my beloved friend, Sheikh Abdul Rashid, he said, "Why do you look so nervous?" So I said, "Oh, I'm not nervous. Alhamdulillah, being a delivery boy in the community for so many years, it's not that it is the crowd that necessarily makes one nervous. But in this particular instance, it is the subject. Because I'm about to, in a very short space of time, I'm about to try to the best of my ability to speak about a man who is the greatest individual to have walked the face of this earth after the Anbiya of Allah. After the prophets and messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nobody more superior, nobody greater, nobody more virtuous and righteous in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu tabaraka wa ta'ala anhu that has walked the face of this earth. So I turn to my Lord and I ask, Ya Allah, if what I say tonight about this great man, if it is correct and it is suitable, فَهَذَا مِن تَوْفِيقِكَ, then that is from your divine guidance. And if I err or do not do justice, then I ask Allah and I ask you all to forgive me. Jamaat al-Muslimin, man hadha rajul? فَإِنَّهُ رَجُلٌ مِنَ الرِّجَالِ. For indeed he is a man amongst men. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu tabaraka wa ta'ala anhu. Whenever we speak about somebody, then we can address them with three different titles at least. Everybody has got at least three names. As the poet says, Sharaf al-Din al-Amriyati, he says, وَمَا أَتَى مِنْهُ بِأُمٍّ أَوْ بِأَبٍ فَكُنْيَةٌ وَغَيْرُهُ اسْمٌ أَوْ لَقَبٌ. That any name that is preceded with the word Abu or Ummu, we call this a kunya. We, as Muslimin, how do we take our kunya? We take it from the name of our eldest son, or the name of our eldest daughter, or because of a praiseworthy trait. The father of so-and-so, or the father of that praiseworthy trait. So if we are to speak about the kunya of Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anh, then it is by that kunya that we know him. And that is Abu Bakr. Wal Bakr huwa al-fatiyu min al-ibl. The word Bakr is that vibrant, lively young camel. And he was fondly addressed as Abu Bakr. And Bakr is also a great tribe. So being called Abu Bakr, it was out of praise for him as being a virtuous young man with beautiful attributes that lived in Makkah al-Mukarramah at that time. As for his name, his ism, which is that which we receive on the seventh day of our birth, his name was Abdullah. His name was Abdullah ibn Uthman ibn Amir ibn Amr ibn Ka'b ibn Taym ibn Murrah ibn Ka'b ibn Lu'ay. Sayyidina Abu Bakr, his nasab meets the nasab, the lineage of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam at Murrah. Murrah ibn Ka'b ibn Lu'ay. You hear the name before Murrah is Taym. And that is why if we speak about the clan of Sayyidina Abu Bakr, then he is from Bani Taym. Our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was from Bani Hashim. And there was Bani Abd al-Shams and Bani Abd al-Dar and many other clans, all from Quraysh. But that is how we know him. He is Abdullah, the son of Uthman, who was known as Abu Quhafa. That was his kunya. His father's kunya was Abu Quhafa. That is why we know him as Abdullah ibn Abi Quhafa. And he was from Taym. At-Taymi al-Qurashi. Radiallahu tabaraka wa ta'ala anhu. So his kunya is Abu Bakr. His name is Abdullah. And now we get to his laqab, his nickname. Nicknames are very common, as they are today. But in Islam, we should only have a nickname that which contains a madh, a praiseworthy trait. Something that people call you by out of praise for you. It is not permissible in Islam to mock somebody with a nickname. وَلَا تَلْمِزُ بِالْأَلْقَابِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, do not mock with nicknames. Now Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he didn't only have one nickname. I'm going to mention four nicknames which show the great attributes and superiority of Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu over the rest of all the companions of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and after the Anbiya, over the rest of creation. The one that we all know him by is of course that nickname of As-Siddiq. As-Siddiq. As-Siddiq, we can translate it as the one who affirms, the one who believes in the truth and affirms it and confirms it. As-Siddiq has also been translated as the saint, the saintly person. For his truthfulness, for his confirming and always believing in the truth. As Shaykh Sa'adullah, in the beginning of this program, as he rightly quoted from the Holy Quran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions him by this wasf, by this characteristic, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالَّذِي جَاءَ بِالصِّدْقِ وَصَدَّقَ بِهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُتَّقُونَ. As for the one who came with the truth. Who is that? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَصَدَّقَ بِهِ. And as for the one who believed in it, who affirmed it, who confirmed it, who is he? Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُتَّقُونَ. Indeed they and they alone are of those who are truly mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We also find in the ahadith of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one day he climbed the Mount of Uhud, and with him was Sayyidina Abu Bakr, and with him was Sayyidina Umar, and with him was Sayyidina Uthman. And there was a slight earthquake and the mountain of Uhud was shaking. So our beloved Prophet said, "Uthbut ya Uhud, fa inna fawqaka nabiyyun wa siddiqun wa shahidan." He said, "Be still, O Uhud, because standing on you is a prophet, a siddiq, this rightful, truly saintful, honest person, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, wa shahidan, and two martyrs." The martyrs he were referring to, of course, were that of Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu, who was assassinated by Abu Lu'lu al-Majusi, Abu Lu'lu, the fire worshipper, and Sayyidina Uthman, who was also assassinated, radiallahu tabaraka wa ta'ala, on ashabi rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ajma'in. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with all the companions of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala referring to him as the one alladhi sadaq. We find our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam referring to him in the hadith as as-siddiq. But where did this title truly come from? What was the event that took place that caused him to earn this title? It was after the Isra wal Mi'raj. After the night journey and the ascension. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from Makkah al-Mukarrama to Bayt al-Maqdis, to Masjid al-Aqsa, and then from there, after leading all the Anbiya in Salah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took him up ila Sidrat al-Muntaha, to the furthest lotus tree and beyond, to have his audience with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam returned from the Isra wal Mi'raj and he informed Quraysh, they laughed at him, they mocked him. They said, "Ah, here we have it. This is our proof that he is mad, that he is a liar, that he is possessed, that what he is speaking is nonsense." And who? The Fir'aun. The Fir'aun of this ummah. Who is he? Abu Jahl. Abu Jahl, he goes out and he meets Sayyidina Abu Bakr in the street. And he says, "Ah, here's my chance. Here's my opportunity." And he says to Abu Bakr, "Did you hear what your companion said? And he claims that in one night he went from Makkah al-Mukarrama to Bayt al-Maqdis to Jerusalem. I mean, can you believe this?" So Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu tabaraka wa ta'ala anhu, he said those famous words, "La'in qala dhalik faqad sadaq." If he said it, and this is the manhaj of Ahl Hadith, this is the methodology of our muhaddithun, those that have preserved the word of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is the methodology. "La'in qala faqad sadaq." If he said it, if it can be verified, because Abu Jahl is a kafir, he is a disbeliever, he is an enemy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his Rasul, so it needs to be verified. But if it is true, if it can be verified that he said it, faqad sadaq, then he has indeed spoken the truth. And he went even further. He had only informed him about the Isra. He hadn't mentioned the Mi'raj. So Sayyidina Abu Bakr after that, he said, "Usaddiquhu bi khabari as-samaa ghudwatan wa rawha." He said, "I will believe him even if he comes with all that is taking place in the heavens, whether it was in the evening or in the morning. Whether it was in the morning or the evening." And yet he hadn't even been informed about the Mi'raj. So indeed, Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he was a Siddiq. And as Asma'i anshada qailan, "Walakin yuhibbu bi kulli qalbi wa a'lamu anna dhaka min as-sawabi Rasulullah wa as-siddiq hubban bihi arju ghadan husna thawabi." He says, "But I love with all my heart and I know that it is right. The messenger and as-siddiq, I hope it will stand me in good stead on the day of division of wrong and right." The next name that we go to, Jamaatul Muslimin, of the great names indicating the superiority of Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu tabaraka wa ta'ala anhu, is that of As-Sahib. As-Sahib. He is As-Siddiq and he is As-Sahib. He is the companion. Now we have words in the Arabic language like Rafiq. We have words in the Arabic language like Sadiq, without the shadda on the dal. Sadiq, al-Rafiq, this is your friend. But al-Sahib, this is something closer. This is your bosom buddy, your companion, somebody that is always with you. By the witness of Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib, karram al-wajh radiyallahu anhu, he always used to say, قام رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وأبو بكر وعمر. دخل رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وأبو بكر وعمر. خرج رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وأبو بكر وعمر. He would say, the messenger of Allah stood up, and with him was Abu Bakr and Umar. The messenger of Allah entered, and with him was Abu Bakr and Umar. The messenger of Allah left, and with him was Abu Bakr and Umar. Sayyidina Abu Bakr was always with our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And it's very difficult to speak about Sayyidina Abu Bakr and then you end up speaking about Sayyidina Umar. And Sayyidina Abu Bakr, he was the soft, compassionate one. And Sayyidina Umar, he was the stern and firm one. But they together were the two wings of Islam. They balanced out Islam. And we always find, and when we speak about the life of Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, being the closest companion to our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, not trailing very far behind, is our beloved companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu tabaraka wa ta'ala anhu. Where did this word come from, as-sahib? Well, remember that in Makkah, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was waiting for the permission from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the hijrah. And Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, the other Sahaba had gone ahead. And Sayyidina Abu Bakr was now waiting but getting anxious. He also wanted to make hijrah. So he went to our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he asked him, Ista'dhana. He sought permission from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to make the hijrah. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to him, La ta'jal. La'alla Allah yaj'al laka sahiba. He said, don't be hasty. It just might be that Allah will grant you a sahib, a companion, a very close companion for your hijrah. So when the permission came, and our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to go to the house of Sayyidina Abu Bakr, either in the morning or in the evening. On that particular day, he came at midday. He came in the middle of the day, al-Dhahira, when the sun is the highest in the sky. When Sayyidina Abu Bakr saw him approaching, he said, something has happened. Something has happened. The Prophet ﷺ entered the house of Sayyidina Abu Bakr. And in the house at that time was Asma bint Abi Bakr and Aisha, as-Siddiqah bint as-Siddiq, the two daughters of Sayyidina Abu Bakr, Asma and Aisha. And so our beloved Prophet Muhammad said to Abu Bakr, إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ أَذِنَ لِي فِي الْخُرُوجِ وَالْهِجْرَةِ. Indeed, Allah has now granted me permission to go out and make the migration, to make the hijrah to Medina al-Munawwara. Said Abu Bakr, he said, like a little child, like a little boy, desiring so much because he so wished that he would be granted the opportunity. 11 days, 11 days, remember? There wasn't just Abu Bakr as a companion in Makkah. There were other companions as well. But for 11 days on that hijrah, he was to be alone with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, drinking from the fountain of prophethood from the morning till the evening and right through the night. And so he said, As-suhba, as-suhba ya Rasulullah. Companionship, big question mark. Companionship, can I be your companion? Beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam nodded and said, As-suhba. You have been granted the companionship. Wallahi, Sayyidina Abu Bakr, he started to sob. He started to cry so much out of joy that Sayyidina Aisha radiallahu anha said, For wallahi, ma sha'artu qad qabla thalika al-yawm anna ahadan yabki min al-farahi hatta ra'aytu Abu Bakr yabki yawma idhin. She said, wallahi, by Allah, I've never ever seen anybody cry so much out of joy like I saw Abu Bakr cry on that day when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam had informed him that he had been chosen to be his companion on the hijrah. And if that's not enough, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then when narrating the story, how does he refer to Sayyidina Abu Bakr? Not mentioned once, not mentioned twice, not mentioned thrice, mentioned four times in the Holy Quran with his different attributes. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refers to him, إِذْ هُمَا فِي الْغَارِ إِذْ يَقُولُ لِصَاحِبِهِ لَا تَحْزَنْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعْنَا. And when the two of them were in the cave, when he, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said to his companion, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu an, don't be afraid, indeed Allah is with us. فَأَنزَلَ اللَّهُ سَكِينَتَهُ عَلَيْهِ فَأَنزَلَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ. Sayyidina Abu Bakr was fearing for the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When the Quraysh came to the door of the cave and the spider had spun a web, the pigeons, that is a weak narration, but the spider had spun a web, and so they didn't enter the cave. They thought that if a spider had spun a web here, nobody could have entered this cave, but that was, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَيَّدَهُ بِجُنُودٍ لَمْ تَرَوْهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He sent soldiers to assist our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in guarding him and protecting him. وَمَا يَعْلَمُ جُنُودَ رَبِّكَ إِلَّا هُوَ. Nobody knows the soldiers of Allah except him. Even the mosquito. A mosquito was a soldier of Allah when it entered into the ear of Nimrod and killed him. The soldiers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all you must have is yaqeen that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will protect you and He will guide you and Allah will show you His soldiers. The soldiers will come, they won't even know that they are soldiers, but they are doing their job that Allah has assigned them to do. So in the Quraysh, when they came and they were standing at the foot of the cave and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Abu Bakr were just below their feet, Abu Bakr said, if they just had to look down, they would see us. So our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, مَا ظَنُّكَ يَا أَبَا بَكَرَ بِثْنَيْنِ اللَّهُ ثَالِثُهُمَا. Abu Bakr, what do you think of two people? The third one with them is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is when this tranquility was descended. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descended this tranquility upon the heart of Abu Bakr. And this is very significant. When you read the rest of the life of Sayyidina Abu Bakr after the hijrah, and you see all the mawaqif, all the great positions and stands that he took in defense of Islam, in defense of the messenger of Islam sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will understand that he got that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put that tranquility into his heart on the day when they were in the cave, when they were making the hijrah. So he is as-sahib. And this is something that has not been granted to anybody but him. Radiallahu tabaraka wa ta'ala an. He was the only one to have made the hijrah with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فهو الصديق وهو الصاحب وهو الأتقى. It's another name mentioned in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وسيجنبها الأتقى الذي يعطي ما له يتزكى. وَمَا لِأَحَدٍ عِنْدَهُ مِنْ نِعْمَةٍ تُجَزَى إِلَّا بَتِغَاءَ وَجِهِ رَبِّهِ الْأَعْلَى وَلَسَوْفَ يَرْضَى. And indeed, the atqa, the most righteous, the most pious, he will be saved from the fire. He who spends of his wealth, not returning a favor, except that he is seeking the pleasure and the countenance of his Lord, and indeed, he will be pleased. Who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala referring to in Surah Al-Layl? Al-Atqa is none other than Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. This ayah was revealed when Sayyidina Abu Bakr was freeing all the slaves. There are many. Of them I can mention Sayyidina Bilal. We all know Sayyidina Bilal ibn Rabah al-Habashi. Sayyidina Bilal, who freed him? Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu spent his money fi nusrati deenillah, in the assistance of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With him was Amir ibn Fuhayra, Shahid Badran, who fought in the Battle of Badr. Amir ibn Fuhayra, he was also freed by Sayyidina Abu Bakr. Ummu Ubais, Zinnira, very beautiful story. Zinnira, they say she was from Bani Adi, some say she was from Bani Makhzun, but she was a slave. And when Sayyidina Abu Bakr freed her, she went blind. So the Quraysh said, you see, Allat wal Uzza has made you blind. She said, Wallahi, the one who took away my sight, Allah, Rabbus Sama, is the one that can restore it. And immediately Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala restored her sight. Zinnira. As well as An-Nahdiya wa binatuha, An-Nahdiya, who was a slave, and her daughter were slaves of a woman from Bani Abdiddar. They were also freed by Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. But you will see right throughout the life of Sayyidina Abu Bakr, he was a good businessman. Very good businessman. But as he made the money, he spent it. As he made it, he spent it. As he made it, he spent it. أُحِبُّ ثَلَاثَةً يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ أُحِبُّ النَّظَرَ إِلَيْكَ وَالْجُلُوسَ بَيْنَ يَدَيْكَ وَإِنْفَاقَ مَالِ عَلَيْكَ. I love three things, O Messenger of Allah. I love the sight of you in my eyes. He always wanted to be with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I love to sit in your company and I love to spend my money on you. Jamaatul Muslimin, our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Abu Bakr ka ghayth, aynama waqa'a nafa. Abu Bakr is like a gentle rain. Wherever he goes, wherever a gentle rain falls, a gentle rain, not a violent storm that can wash away a crop. But a ghayth is a gentle rain, is the most beneficial rain. Aynama waqa'a nafa. Wherever it falls, it produces beautiful vegetation. Likewise, Abu Bakr, he is like that gentle rain. Wherever he goes, he benefits. He benefits people. He spends of his wealth in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا نَفَعَنِي مَالٌ مَا نَفَعَنِي مَالُ أَبِي بَكْرٍ. And no money has benefited me more, says the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, than the wealth of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. فَبَكَى أَبُو بَكْرٍ. So Abu Bakr cried. He had a very, very raqiq al-qalb. He was very, very soft hearted. Whenever he used to recite the Quran, he used to cry. When he heard these words, he began to cry. And he said, Ya Rasulullah, wa hal ana wa mali illa lak. He said, O Messenger of Allah, I and my wealth are nothing except but for you, O Messenger of Allah. And that takes us, of course, to the story of when Sayyidina Umar came with his wealth. It was for the Battle of Tabuk. And the Prophet ﷺ was gathering from the Sahaba for the expedition. And Sayyidina Umar came with half of his wealth. And the Prophet ﷺ asked him, وَمَاذَا أَبَقَيْتَ لِأَهْلِكَ يَا Umar? Umar came with half of his wealth. And so the Prophet ﷺ asked him, what have you left for your family, O Umar? And Sayyidina Umar on this day, he said, today I'm going to beat Abu Bakr. Today I'm going to beat him. What have you left for your family, O Umar? He said, أَبَقَيْتَ أُمَّ nisf. I've left for them half, O Messenger of Allah. So Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he came with his wealth. And the Prophet ﷺ asked him, وَمَاذَا أَبَقَيْتَ لِأَهْلِكَ يَا أَبَا بَكْرِ. What have you left for your family, O Abu Bakr? He said, أَبَقَيْتُهُمَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ. I have left for them Allah and His Messenger. Said Bakr said, Wallahi, I'm not. Said Umar said, Wallahi, I'm not going to try and beat Abu Bakr after this day. So that brings us to another name, which is an unofficial name. An unofficial name. Said Ali radiallahu anhu, Karamallahu wajhahu radiyallahu anhu, he said, Kana Abu Bakr sabbaqan. Abu Bakr radiyallahu anhu, he was first. He was always first. We would never ever try and compete with him, says Sayyidina Ali, except that Sayyidina Abu Bakr, he would always come first. Now, one might be thinking, what is this first? Is there a race? Is there a competition? Well, yes, in khayrat, in good deeds, in doing good, in being good, there is a competition in Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَسَابِقُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ فَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَاتِ. Race with each other in seeking a forgiveness from your Lord and a paradise with which, with, which width is greater than the heavens and the earth prepared for those who are mindful of Allah. Wasari'u, and hasten towards a forgiveness from your Lord and a paradise. فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ, let them race with each other, make competition with each other in seeking reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَاتِ, make competition with each other in doing good deeds, says Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But not in dunya. In dunya, we're not supposed to make competition with each other. We're not supposed to vie with each other. And you can still go to the Arab world, in the Al-Mudan Al-Qadima, in the old cities, and you can see one whole row of barbers, all cutting hair. One whole row of butchers, all selling meat. One whole row of people selling vegetables. One whole row of people selling garments. One whole row of people selling perfume. There's no competition. Everybody believes that their rizq has been put out for them for that day. And so they go to work. And what they used to do was, if some customers had already come to the one man, he would then close his shop so that some customers could come to his brother who was selling exact same wares alongside him. But we've changed it around. We make competition for the dunya, and there's no competition for the akhirah. Are we even worrying about the akhirah? I'm just asking the question. Kullu wahidin adra bi nafsi. Everybody knows themselves better than anybody else. But our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has warned us, Jamaat al-Muslimin. He said, Wallahi lal faqra akhsha alaykum walakinni akhsha alaykum an tuftah alaykum ad-dunya. Walakinni akhsha an tuftah alaykum ad-dunya fatunafisuha kama tanafasuha man kana qablakum fatuhlikukum kama ahlakatum. He said, I don't fear poverty for you. You know, even two or three generations ago, I was on Pratfani Umainsa. They had so little, but yet they were so contented. Alhamdulillah for the bitchy what they get. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.